Cybercrime is everywhere. Credit unions face potential vulnerabilities in payment systems and operations. Even credit union employees face cybersecurity threats. No credit union is immune. But there's help through the Cybersecurity Assessment Tool, released by the Federal Financial Institutions Examination Council. The Cybersecurity Assessment Tool identifies risks and weaknesses in cybersecurity preparedness programs. Let's examine the inherent risk profile and cybersecurity maturity. Before implementing controls, credit unions must first assess and develop an inherent risk profile. The profile identifies activities, services, and products in the following domains: wireless access, volume of network devices, end-of-life systems, cloud services, internet, and third-party connections. All of these pose a higher risk, depending on the complexity, maturity, and nature of the products and services. Delivery channels address whether products and services are available online through mobile delivery or ATMs. Payment services like debit and credit cards, person-to-person payments, automated clearinghouse, wire transfer services, and other payment services. All of these credit union services may pose a higher inherent risk. Organizational characteristics such as mergers and acquisitions, number of direct employees, cybersecurity contractors, changes in security staffing, changes in technology, and location of operations and data centers. All of these characteristics may pose risks. Cyber attacks, whether attempted or successful, affect a credit union's inherent risk exposure. This domain considers the volume and sophistication of these attacks. Each domain may pose a different level of inherent risk, ranging from least, minimal, moderate, significant, or most inherent risk. Management determines the overall risk level based on the type, volume, and complexity of the operations and the potential threats. After a credit union identifies its inherent risk profile, the next step is to assess its maturity level. The tool looks at a credit union's preparedness in five key areas: cyber risk management and oversight, threat intelligence and collaboration, cybersecurity controls, external dependency management, and cyber incident management and resilience. Within these areas are assessment factors to help credit unions determine maturity levels of their cybersecurity programs. They include the following: baseline, evolving, intermediate, advanced, and innovative. First, a credit union must identify and review its inherent risk profile and maturity levels across the domains. Then, management can make a determination as to whether the company's maturity levels are appropriate in relation to its risk. Credit union management can then choose to either reduce the level of risk or to increase the levels of maturity as appropriate. Credit unions will find several other resources to supplement the Cybersecurity Assessment Tool. These include an overview for the chief executive officers and board members, a user's guide, and an online presentation on the Federal Financial Institutions Examination Council website. Credit unions can learn more about the tool and NCUA's implementation plan in the agency's flagship publication, the NCUA REPORT. Credit unions can also find a wealth of information on cyber threats, tactics, and preventive measures on NCUA's Cybersecurity Resource page.